Hello and welcome to E! Magazine. I'm your host, Brenton Emichaba. On E! Magazine today, we look at the esports gaming industry. Now, the esports gaming is booming. It's a booming global industry where skilled video gamers play competitively. In the same way that traditional sports have competitions in baseball, basketball, football, esports encompasses competitions across a variety of video games. Contrary to common perception, esports is not simply a phenomenon occurring in the basements of unemployed 20-somethings. The industry is real, growing globally and investable. Now today we have two representatives from one of Kenya's best known esports company, AcePro Gaming, who will help us understand the role esports gaming plays in the growth of the Kenyan gaming industry. Now joining me right now in E-Magazine is Davy Kamanzi, and he is the founder of Tekken 254. Welcome to E-Magazine, thank you so much for joining me.
Thank you for having me, it's a pleasure to be here.
Great, so we're just gonna jump right into, obviously, me asking you, what is esports? Because a lot of people don't understand. When you just say esports to them, they're like, okay, what are you talking about?
So basically, esports is competitive gaming. So any game that can be played 1v1, 2v2, 3v3 on a competitive stage can be considered as an esport. So FIFA, you look at games like FIFA, Tekken, Mortal Kombat, League of Legends, any game that can be played competitively between two people or two teams can be considered as an esport.
Okay, great. And what would you say is the state of the gaming industry in Kenya right now?
So gaming itself in Kenya, as I understand it, has been around for a very long time. People have been playing games in Kenya for a long time. And there's a lot of enthusiasm for gaming in Kenya. But in terms of esports now, competitive gaming, it's the industry is still really young in Kenya. It's only in 2016, 2017, when we started seeing some real activity in the space. For example, Tekken 12, when AcePro Gaming, we held our first tournament in November of 2017. Other entities like Pro Series Gaming, Holos Gaming and such like started holding competitions on a regular basis around 2017. So the space is still really young, but it's growing at a fast pace because there's a lot of enthusiasm for the space, as I said.
Okay, and you mentioned that 2017 was the first time you had the Tekken competition. What was the reaction? What would you say Kenyans saw gaming at that time?
So even now, it's like when you talk about gaming, video games, people still look at it as like a hobby. It's like this is something for kids and stuff like that. So like people like us were trying to switch the narrative and show people this is an industry that you can make a living from. So when we first held, when we held our first tournament, we had about 24 players turn up, so it was really small. But we noticed that there was a lot of enthusiasm for it, and we said, why don't we turn this into a league and try and professionalize it? So we started a competition called the Tekken 254 circuit. So it's like there's a qualifying phase, and at the end of the season, there's a final tournament.
Okay.
So yeah, we're trying to, everything we do, we're trying to make it professional so that people see this as, this is not just a hobby anymore, this is a job.
Okay, great. And what are some of the processes, you know, people who want to compete in these leagues, they have to go through in order to qualify for it?
So a lot of them like ours, it's open registration, you can just sign up. But I feel like others, there could be other processes you have to go through. But for the large majority of them, you can just sign up. If you feel like you have the skills, you just sign up and go for it.
Okay, and what kind of prizes do you give these competitors at the end of the day?
So yeah, prize money, there's prize money. The second season of our circuit, we had Dell come in as a sponsor. The winner got a laptop worth 150,000 shillings.
Wow, that's amazing.
So yeah, there's a lot in it for players who sign up and yeah.
Okay.
It's an exciting time.
Now another thing I just wanted to know is, especially within the Kenyan League, what games are played the most and what games are popular?
So the moment, FIFA, of course. FIFA is massively popular, yeah, because Kenyans love football. But fighting games as well, Tekken and Mortal Kombat, I'd say, are the two major ones right now. And there's some underground scenes doing competitions for first-person shooters like Call of Duty and other shooter games like Fortnite and stuff like that, yeah. So I'd say FIFA, fighting games and first-person shooters.
No car racing games in that mix?
Not really.
I'm guessing Kenyans are not interested in that as much. Another thing I just wanted to look at is, you know, a lot of people, when you talk about esports, and maybe they do know what it is, they tend to see, you know, gaming as not a sport. So I just wanted to for you to tell me your views on that, and if you are putting any things in place to kind of sway away these perceptions and misconceptions about, you know, esports.
So what I feel like, as with normal sports, in esports there's a lot of not as much physical exertion, because for the most part you are sat down and you're playing, but there's some, there's a lot of tactics that go into it, there's a lot of mental activity that goes into it, and just like athletes in normal sports, I call them traditional sports, esports athletes have to put in hours and hours and hours practicing to get good at the game, get improve their skills, review footage from previous tournaments to see where they went wrong, what they can improve on. So
it's
just
a whole
like
job.
Yeah, so just like in traditional sports, esports players put a lot of time into the game, analyzing their gameplay, practicing, discussing with their teammates if it's a team game like Call of Duty, so that they can get better and improve their results in the next tournament. So yeah, there's because of that competitive aspect, just like traditional sports, you have to put a lot of time to be the best you can be. Yeah. So I think in terms of changing that perception that esports isn't a sport in Kenya, I guess in my view, the best we can do is perform at the highest level we can in national and international tournaments, and show people that these are people who've put a lot of time into the game, and they've become these high-level players that, that people can look up to. Yeah.
And let's talk about the sponsors. Do you find that a lot of sponsors interested in, you know, sponsoring esports around here in Kenya?
There's been support, but I feel like corporate stakeholders could do more to support the space. So as I said, Dell came in as a sponsor for the second season of our circuit, but there's other companies like Liquid Telecom and stuff like that, internet service providers in general, because you know, gamers need internet, you know what I mean?
Yeah, it's technology, 100%.
So, but I feel like a lot more support to be given could be given to these competitions in terms of improving the quality of the service, so gamers at home can have a better experience in terms of practicing with other players from around the world. And then also putting more money into esports competitions, because as they gain exposure, that's an opportunity for them to market themselves as well. So yeah, and also support from the government in terms of putting legislation in place to make it easier for esports organizers to organize competitions and recognize esports as an actual sport.
Yeah. An actual sport that can actually be a multi-billion industry if they actually pay attention to it.
Yeah.
Now, you hold different competitions each and every year, of course. Do you see the community growing each and every year from 2017 to 2018 to 2019? And do you see it even going further in the future?
Yeah, definitely. We've seen quite a bit of growth in our competitions. The player base has been growing, and we've had spectators come to our competitions as well. So as I think these competitions become more noticeable, people are seeing this and being like, "Oh, this this is something that's happening. I didn't realize. Let me go there and test my skills." We've had players come in and tell us like, "Before I came here, I thought I was good at the game, and I came here and I got absolutely destroyed. So now I know I need to get better," and stuff like that. So yeah, that enthusiasm has really encouraged us, and we see that continuing in the coming years as well.
Great. Well, thank you so much, Davey, for, you know, sharing that information. I'm hoping, as much as I've learned about esports so far, the viewers here are learning the same thing. Now we're going to take a short commercial break, and when we come back, I'll be joined by the co-founder of Ace Pro Gaming, who's going to give me more details and information about the esports right now here in Kenya. Don't go anywhere. You're watching E! Magazine.